Hey everyone, it's Thursday night, and that means hacking stream. I had to think about it for a second, like I couldn't remember what it is we were doing here today. Alright, hey, we got a good crowd starting off today. Normally it takes a little bit of time to pick up some steam, but looking good. Looking good. How is everyone doing tonight? I'm doing well. I've been having a good week. I've been getting a lot done. One of such things is extremely, extremely frivolous. Let me show you. Ta-da! So you guys are gonna have to let me know as long as that chat still looks okay, because I can't tell from my, my preview on OBS. That always looks distorted to me. So let me know if you guys can't read, the chat. And as long as you can read chat, I'm going to leave this background up because it's awesome. We're in 5 hours or so playing Final Fantasy IX, doing nothing but killing Grand Dragons to power up Dragon's Crest. Well, that's cool. Lacks contrast, but it's readable if you focus. All right, I might have to look into that's true, you can read your chat, but for people that are watching this video later, either on YouTube or on my channel, my Twitch channel, they should be able to see the chat. So I would like it to be at least somewhat legible. There are a couple things I could do to fix that. I could do something like, wait, I forget how I do that. I can make this smaller here and then go up to OBS, not that, Twitch chat, and make that a little bit bigger here. So let me know if that helps. I don't want to get it to the point where you can't see anything on the screen. But hopefully that does the trick. Hopefully that's enough of a difference there. Maybe I can make that single panel darker next week. But we're going to run with this for today, because why not? Because it's adorable. Because that's what Moogles are. Moogles are adorable. Just don't tell any Moogles I said that, because they would probably kill me in my sleep. Anyway, so... Like I said, I got a lot done this week. Let me bring up my files here. And that's not actually what I want to see. I want to be looking at this. So I got a few things done. I finished my Vargas sprite sheet. And I had to make a secondary sprite for him in order to get him to work in battle because of the way that the palettes work. Nah. Moogles are essential to Final Fantasy games. That's why 8 did so poorly. It had the Moombas, which were cool. Don't get me wrong, but they're no Moogle. So anyway, I'm going to showcase some of the stuff that I went over this week, because some of the stuff could be actually helpful for people. I think this Vargas stuff is actually really neat. So for a long time, it's always been really frustrating to be stuck with 12 colors in a palette. Now, the way that I have done this is you still only have 12 colors. You have 12 total colors, but you can use any 12 that you want. Now, a few years ago, a person by the name of Eggers came on and made a patch for Final Fantasy that was supposed to do this, and it works moderately well. But one of the people it did not work for was Vargas. Where am I at? Do I have the wrong? There we go. It did not work for Vargas, and it did not work for Vargas because the skin tones, and you see these up here, had to stay in place. And his patch assumes, at least that's from what I gather, Well, I like 8. Okay, I like 8, but I was just making a point about the Moogles. But it wasn't well received. Anyway, so his patch, from what I gather, assumes that everyone uses these two colors for skin tone. And so these ones were set in stone. The reason why those ones are set in stone is because certain statuses, like Berserk and Poison, use those in order to change the look of your character. And so the problem I was running into is Vargas doesn't actually use both of... Well, he uses one of those colors, but not both of them. And so what was happening was that one of the colors was already taken, which means I couldn't use my full 12, which means one of mine got bumped off the list and got replaced by other stuff. And so even with Egger's patch, I couldn't get Vargas to work in battle, and it has been a constant source of frustration for me. So what I ended up doing was, after I finished Vargas, I went ahead and I made a secondary sprite sheet where I loaded him up in a different color with the colors rearranged in the palette. And so what I did was I moved the battle palettes to another location, imported his sprite, his secondary sprite, to another location, and then made his battle sprite and his battle palette those new ones. And so that way I technically have two Vargas sprites, one for overworld, one for battle. But they look exactly the same because of all the stuff. Okay, so this is the Vargas I came up with. I'm pretty happy with it. The hair transformations were a pain, but I think I did pretty well. I was pretty happy with the way that they came out. His kneeling sprite was fun. It is technically a custom pose. I took Sabin's, whatever you want to call him, and I basically switched which leg was up and which leg was down. So you can see kind of his left knee here is kind of up and his right knee is down. Well, with Vargas, I essentially reversed that. And then kind of had his, like, I don't know, his fist out or something, or like, I don't know. But I think it looks cool, and it actually looks good in gameplay. And the way that I test these normally is I put them in the place of Wedge, because Wedge is pretty animated in some of my opening sequences. So we can go ahead and look at that, because I want to. Turn my volume down a little bit. Not without doing anything. Yeah, where I can actually do that, though, where I can do that, is I can... I don't want to give you guys that. Sprites, PCs, Vargas. It won't be animated here, but... So yeah, so this is what I got. What I do with his finger wag, I kind of like put one of his arms in, and you can't see that on my camera. Kind of put one of his arms in, he's kind of going like that. Hopefully it just doesn't look like it. It kind of looks like he's armless, but you can also kind of see the arm. So you guys can tell me if that looks good, I don't know. That's one sprite that does not actually appear in the sequence I'm going to show you guys. I'm actually going to go ahead... Oh, by the way, this is another thing. So, splash screen, this is temporary. I will probably embellish that a bit more. So, updated splash screen. And... I'm going to turn that down because I do not want it doubled. All right. Fast forward. And they also updated it so that it's using the Final Fantasy VI one rather than the Final Fantasy III one. All right. So let me go to here, and so you guys can kind of see Vargas move about a bit. So that looks pretty good. I like the way that that transitioned. See, the big thing with me is the transitions have to look natural to me. Like, some sprites just don't like line up well when they change from position to position. Yeah. I'm just trying to see poses here. You guys have all seen this part before. Vargas got it. Or not Vargas, Wedge got a tan. All right, so side looking sprite, that looked pretty good. And then he's about to look down to the side. That one probably took the most tweaking to get it where I was comfortable with it. So that took some work to get that one. That one was a little bit rough. That's a hard transformation to do. Look, punk. You know what I don't have is his like surprise sprite. That actually takes place earlier in the cave, but that's fine. Alright, the only other one here to show off is him facing forward looking down, which is another hair transformation, which is another reason that I spend a lot of time looking at those, because those ones are really easy to make look bad. See? That looks good. I had to make his little ponytail come up. And so that looked a little weird at first, but I think the final product came out well. Alright. Yeah. Let's go back to here. Yeah, and you guys can see in the OAM data, which is the save state, the save screens, and the like shop menus and stuff like that, he's still gonna look messed up. One day I will have to tackle that. I'm glad you approve, Kyuga. Naming way? No, he's actually going to be in the he'll be in the tutorial building, like right at the very beginning there. All right, so yeah, I've got Vargas here, and we get to watch him in battle. Because, yay! In fact, I don't know if you guys remember, but I told you at one point that Vargas was the first character that I made a sprite for, and here he is, and that's actually a totally different sprite. It looks like the same sprite, but it's not. And so, I'll bum rush and everything. And so I had to get a second sprite and a second palette to stick in there. And I'll show you how I did that, because other people should be able to do this as well. Now I do have a tutorial somewhere about adding more sprite sheets. So I'm not going to really touch on that, but I will show you what I did with the battle palettes. Let me think. Yeah, there's other stuff, but I'll do that later. Wait, what? You spotted something you're looking for? Is it me you're looking for? Doot. Alright. Let's close that. Of course it's going to crash on me. I was just trying to close it anyway. That is the 5 damage numerals patch. I got that probably on Slick Forum somewhere. I'm not sure where I got that. It's to make it so you can have 5-digit damage. You can have up to 32,000 damage per hit. So that's what that is. And so they had to shrink the numbers in order to get them all fit in the video RAM. All right, so what I was going to show you, my code. And I should have something in here for... maybe that's not here. Expanded sprites. So yeah, so here's all the sprite sheets. And down at the bottom here, I just added the Vargas battle recolor. And the battle palettes, I moved from their original location, which is, if we open up, let's open up Children of Vector, but I also want to open up my debug copy. My debug copy is where I basically just test a bunch of stuff, and so there's all sorts of random stuff messed up in there. I mean, you don't technically have to. You can do what I did, and in fact, I don't even know if that necessarily changes the damage cap for you. It just makes it available. And then I don't remember. You'd have to read the thing. So I don't know. The problem is I didn't do that myself. It was a patch. So, and that's what it does. And what I do is I actually artificially limit it back down to 9999 damage, with the exception of abilities that I want to go higher than that, which I set a special bit on so that I can control what breaks the damage cap and what doesn't break the damage cap. Anyway, all right, so this is where the battle palettes are normally stored, and they're separate from the overworld palettes. And so what was that? That was ED6300. So go to 2D6500 is what that would be. All right, so this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, I think. I think there's 8 battle palettes total. So all those right there, I had to move. So this is palette 0, palette 1, palette 2, palette 3, palette 4. And so I essentially picked all those up and I moved those to 5, 4, F, 8 would be 9A00. So I moved those here, and then at the end I added a reordered palette 4 to put all the colors that Vargas uses in the first 12 so that it doesn't require any changing. Okay, so this is that palette. In fact, I believe I still have that palette loaded in my debug copy, so you can actually see what that looks like. Yeah, so this is it right here, reordered. And you see that I put Vargas's skin tone colors right where the skin tones go. In fact, that was actually the wrong one, and it's actually... whatever, I have a lot of Vargas in here. I think I overwrote it on 4. Here we go, this is the one. So this is all of Vargas's colors here, and these are his 4 unused colors. And so that is this palette right here. And there's absolutely nothing in the code stopping it from reading higher palette numbers. So literally all you have to do is relocate it so that you have space to stick it in there, and then change his battle palette to 8. And then, and you see I don't have the original one on here. All the colors would be messed up if I was looking at that in the original palette 4. He would look very, very different. Oh boy. Hi, Dastern. How's it going? Please don't spam my chat. I will break your bot over my knee. All right. Anyway, so ever since college, like a long time ago now, I've been trying to get Vargas to work. And I finally, ever since the first time I did a Vargas sprite sheet and tried to take it into battle and was so confused as to why all the colors look messed up, finally, this last week, I have a working Vargas, and I am so happy. All right. So that's how that works. For anyone who would like to use characters that go beyond the color set, that's how you can do it. It is totally doable. It does not take that much space, as long as you're not using like a ton of people. But you probably would not want to do this for every single character. Although, I expanded my ROM up to 6 megabytes, so it is now double the size of the original ROM, so there was plenty of space. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and throw this out here now, actually. I told you guys I had a special announcement about production. Well, Zatris, here on the chat, is my brother, and he is the brother that was doing scripting for me for Children of Vector. This was our story for years and years and years. And as of this week, he's officially coming back and starting scripting again for me. So I have someone to do all of that for me so that I don't have to figure it all out myself. So this makes... I've got a lot of brothers. Oh yeah, you know that. So that's going to make things a lot smoother for me. It means when I get to doing events, I can follow the script and just get events put in there. I don't have to make it up and make up subpar script and then try to put actions to it. I have someone that is actually good at this, doing this for me. So that is a huge plus. So we are like back in full swing here. So good stuff. Good. All right. Kill the expanded sprites. Let's go back to history. All right. What else did I do? That stuff was already in there. All right. Updated the splash and title screen. I applied my AI upgrade patch. And there's kind of some cool stuff in there. I'm going to show that off real quick before we really get in. I made my March of the Moogles wallpaper, which you all see and love because it's adorable. That's just a minor thing here. So yeah, the AI upgrade patch is the last thing here. I do kind of want to show that off a little bit. I want to show you guys a little bit of the stuff that you can do. I probably shouldn't do this in this ROM, but whatever. I've got it backed up. All right, so if I go into the battle script, and this is for the guard, so it's like the very first battle of the game. I can go in here and I can add some stuff. So hex insert. I don't have the list in front of me of the commands. I can find that though. I am in my code. All right, AI upgrade. So all this stuff changes to targeting. And then yeah, so the targeting byte, I can do this. Oops, let's go back to here. So if I do F1, and what did I say? For target front row, actually let's do target front row, because that one is actually like different. Is 4E. So it will say targeting and it has no idea what, because this doesn't know how to do it. But I can target that and then hex insert and we'll just throw fire out there. All right, so for targeting and for good measure, let's go ahead and change a couple other things. For the miscellaneous here, no worries, Lock Kirby. Just showing off some stuff, including BAM. So we can change the music, change the background, and we can change the status of the Fanatics Tower debuff. And we can jump bites, but I'll show that momentarily. All right, so let's change the background, because that'll be fun. So that's OF, FBOF. So after he does fire, let's hex insert FBOF 13, whatever that is. In fact, I want to check, because I would like to change it to a specific one here. All right, so that should be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9... A, B, C, D, E, F, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, oh, come on, 18, 19, 18, B, C, D, E, why am I doing all this? All right, I lost track. I was going to do the fire one, but you know what? I'm just going to change it to desert. Or, you know, I'll just change it to whatever the heck 13 was, because that's what I put in there. All right, cancel that. All right, so FBOF is change background. And then let's also set up fanatics so that we can only use magic and items. So the morph timer, enable fanatics is bit zero. I guess that's bit one. But hex insert, well, I guess bit zero in the number, but it's, never mind. That kind of thing. So that's FB10, and then we'll do 01. And 01 should turn on fanatics. We can also change things with the morph timer, but we're not using morph, like, at all in this game. Okay, so what should happen? He should do a normal attack, then he'll cast fire on the entire front row. The background will change, and then Fanatic's tower should turn on, and we should only be able to cast magic. All right, so let's give that a shot. Make sure that that is doing what it is supposed to do. Moogles, including not that. Did I say not that? I'm gonna fast forward through this. And then, because I want to, I'll set the Moogles. And then I will save state so that I don't have to do this again when I change stuff. Alright. Oh, shoot. I forgot to change the row. Hold on. I'm going to go ahead and move Terra to the back row. And we'll watch Wedge and Vix burn. Alright. So, assuming all of my AI upgrade things worked, some things should happen. Of course. Alright. And then watch what's going to happen, too. It should. I think it's going to change without me having to do anything. So, he did that. Now, fire should hit Wedge and Vix. And it does. Oh, the background didn't change. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. And Fanatic's Tower didn't set up. Okay, well, I did something wrong. Or I put it in the wrong spot. See? Already doing things wrong. Hey, Sir Knight dude. Showing off some upgrades to the AI that I did. Oh, I put it in the... I put it in the wrong spot. I put it in the counter code. Let's do that. Come on. All right, let's try that again. Now it should work. Why always the preemptive strike? Doesn't look at the magic armor when he moved forward. What are you talking about? Oh, actually, I think that always happens. All right, see, it changed. And Fanatic's Tower got set up. See, now I only have magic on here. So, those all things happened. I think that always happens, actually. I don't know if that always happens. I didn't change anything. All right, so now we did all that. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to use my new patented jump command to skip over casting fire. In fact, I'll skip over the targeting also. So we'll hex insert FB 11, and then how many bytes is that? Targeting is 2 bytes and fire is 1 byte, so we're going to go 03. Okay, so what that should do is it'll read this and it'll jump 3 bytes. It'll go 1, 2, 3. It's just like in the ASM coding. When you branch forward or branch back, it works exactly the same way. It can branch backwards, it can branch forwards. Okay, so we're branching 1, 2, 3 bytes. And we should pick up here with the change. So now I won't get whacked by fire, But the background should still change, and Fanatic's Tower should get set. And actually, while I'm at it, not that it matters in any way, shape, or form, I'm going to change this so that instead I'm going to change the music to whatever song 13 is, or 1-3, technically. All right. That back up. No, I know what you're talking about, Kyuga. I'm just... Yeah, see, sometimes it doesn't do it for either of them. I think it's just a timing thing. All right, so they should hit. There'll be no fire cast. All right, well, it did change, but the background didn't change. Oh, that's right. The music was supposed to change, and I just don't have it volume turned up for me. What song is that? I want to see. Oh, nice chocobo theme. All right. Well, there you go. So, that stuff works. That stuff works. Did I put anything else interesting in there? Chocobo! Yeah, there's different targeting things, but they all basically work. Branching bites. Oh, that's right, and the conditionals, which get changed. But I'm not really... I don't need to do all that. Take my word for it, it works. So, things you can check for now that you couldn't before are... things like defend, certain statuses that are set by having relics equipped. So you can check for all sorts of different stuff. You can check for economizer, offering, black belt, true knight. And then you can also have, you check for elemental statuses, which I think this is kind of, that's kind of a big one, especially for AI, because people tend to abuse things like absorbing elements, and so people avoid using elements in boss battles because they're very easily avoided, and so this way you can work around that. So if they absorb, nullify, are weak to, or resist an element, you can now detect that with the with your boss script. All right, so I'm not gonna really show off any more of that. I think the fun stuff is like Fanatic's Tower and the music and background changes. Those are really cool. Alright, I'm going to delete that, delete that, delete that, delete that, delete that. Alright, we're back to normal. Alright. Alright, so that's all the stuff that I did this week. And now we're going to take the next hour to kind of start cracking into some of this stuff. This is what we're doing. All right. So I'm assuming please email me is DastyBot, or were they just saying DastyBot over and over again? Because I don't want to be rude and be like I'm just ignoring somebody, but if it's a bot, I'm not going to waste my time talking to it. All right, so this is something I'll do on my own. It's pretty minor naming way. I'm waiting for someone to send me a sprite for that. L'Oreal's trance targeting, that's probably something we might work on tonight if we get that far. I can't do the minor event edits first because a lot of the events I need to change involve I need to expand my music first, so that's the first thing I'm going to do. Okay. Well, if you are a person, then I apologize. Okay, sorry, you are a person. Alright, anyway, so yeah. So I need to expand the music first before I do most of those edits. I think only like one or two of those edits are actually an edit I need to make in the event itself, rather than just like changing a music cue. And then there's a couple things I need to do in the script. But that'll come later after I get some feedback from Zatris, who is my scripter. Huh. Yikes. Yeah, I don't want to jump the gun. But yeah. So I will do that. But it's like really, really small stuff. But if we get there, we'll do that. That I'll start working on myself this week. This I might do on stream. Probably not today though. And that's something I'll end up doing myself also. So yeah, so what I really wanted to do, what the first thing I want to do is I want to do expand music. And Magic 2.0 here. Magic. I have a post about that on the forums. So we're going to start working through that, about updating the Magic system to free up some SRAM and make it so there's a bunch of shareable lists, and there's going to be like a bunch of them. So anyone who wanted to add additional characters will be able to do that, and at the same time save RAM. The only thing it gives up is learning magic through equipping weapons. But that's okay. That's a really small price to pay, I think, for having more magic lists and more save RAM space. Like, that's a big deal. Pass the Turing test. Alright, so let's get to expanding the music, because a lot of people do that, and this is actually my first time actually doing this, but I kind of looked it over and it looks actually pretty straightforward, and I've got a couple songs to put in, so we're going to do that. Alright, so Geen Attack wrote a nice little tutorial on this a while back, and I'm going to be following this basically. And I wish he was on the stream. Is he on the stream right now? I don't know. Let's see who's on the stream. Bing. I got those people. I don't see Geen Attack. Okay. Well, it's whatever. If there's anyone else in here who's done this before, if I run into any problems, I'm going to ask you. Yeah, someone go get him. Alright. So anyway, it says there are normally 55 songs. It's actually 85 songs, but it's in hex 55. 55. But that's right. I don't think I'm going to be adding that many anyway. And so there's a few things we need to do. We need to... So each song, there is the data for the instruments, what instruments get used, and what their IDs are, so that when the code for the actual music is calling it, it's calling the proper instrument sample. So we've got a list of those for each and every song, and then we have the song data for each and every song, and then we have pointers to each one of those. Okay, so what I need to do is I need to relocate the instrument data, which should free up room for the pointer list, and then I don't remember about expanding the pointer list for the songs itself. I might need to move like a song or something like that to make room for that. So we're going to find out. I don't know. So they're normally hex 5/5 songs in the FF6 ROM. It can be edited up to 120 songs. It's really nice to add songs. First thing to do is relocate table of sample indexes for each song. So that means the list of instruments that it's going, that the song's going to use. And we've got an address to any other place where there's more space. Well, it just so happens that I have a lot of space. All right, so let's get over there. That's C53F95. Let's scoot this over here so I can see that. All right, and so we're going to go to, so what that's going to look like in our raw with a headered ROM is 54195. Because we're adding 2 to this F for the header, and we drop the C for the raw. Okay, so that gives us 54195. That first song is a blank song. So yes, this is the instruments here. Two. And how far does this go? This goes all the way down to 4A3-4. So this can be 4C3-4. And it probably should be pretty obvious when we get down there, because the data is just going to start looking different. But look how much there is just for this. 4C... Wait, what? What did I say it was? 4C3-4. This is just the list of instruments for each song. 3-4. So that's right there. Yeah, and you can see, like, right after that, the way that the data looks in the ROM looks totally different. Okay, so this is all of our instruments for each and every song in the ROM. And I'm going to control copy. Copy. And I've already picked a location to save this. And we're going to be going to 480200. So we're going to be at the beginning of the 48 bank. Okay. I'm just going to drop them all in there. So control paste. All right. So this is a new bank that I just added. And it's 48 slash and then with the header. Again, with the 2 there. Okay. And the reason that's there, and I think most people here know that, is at the beginning of the ROM, this right here, this 200 hex, is all zeros. That is totally optional. So you can have a ROM either with that or without it. But if you have it, all of your addresses basically get offset by that 200. It is basically just a buffer, and I'm not sure exactly what it's there for. If somebody knows, let me know. So anyway, so I relocated all those. And so now I'm going to have to change the code that tells you where that is so that it's now looking in the right place. All right, so to any other place where there's more space, I recommend expanded F banks. Well, I went to the 4-8 bank. Just make sure that USME is not using the bank for something else. I don't have to worry about that because USME doesn't use the banks that I'm using. Or it'll be overwritten. Next step is to change code at C501E2 to the new address of the instruments. Okay, so now we have to show it. Excuse me. So now we need to show it in the code that that's where it's going to be looking for the instrument samples. Because it doesn't do... You can't just move the data because the game doesn't know what the heck that is. It's just a chunk of data there. So when it's actually processing, it needs to be told where to go. Okay? And we'll actually... that's actually in C5, and I don't have a disassembly for that. So never mind. So we'll go back over to our hex editor. And we're going to go to 503E2. 503E2. All right, so that should be C501E2. And he says it should be this right here, BF953FC5. BF953FC5. So that's it. All right. And we're going to put our new location in there. And something to note, when you're doing these calls and most things in hex, you're going to see that those... how do you keep track of things where are in the code in so many places? Should every change... So that's kind of what I'm explaining right now. So in this section of the code, it's telling you where to go in the raw hex. So this is a static thing. Okay, so when you're... And someone correct me if I'm wrong, because I don't do... I have very, very limited experience with writing code in like an assembler. But what I'm working with is something that is in place. So when you write with an assembler, you use like headers and stuff like that, and all of this stuff in the raw location is done for you. What I'm doing is I'm moving stuff in the actual raw location, so that is static. So when I change where it's called from, I'm changing it to that location. I'm changing it to that physical location. Okay, so I didn't take anything out. If I go back to the original location where the songs were, 5354195, you'll see all the data's still there. I didn't take it out, so I didn't chop it out. It's still there. It's just I'm not going to have anything go to it. So hypothetically, I can take all of this and I can just change it all to blank. Okay? And I'm going to actually do that because I would like to, if I come through here later and need space, be able to just look at it. Okay? And what am I going down to? See something? Yeah, wow, man, that is a lot of free space. Holy cow. 3, 4, I'm going to do it from like here and see what that takes me to. There, so let me go here. Let me go 3, 4. One more down. There we go. Right to 3, 4. I did not get 5, did I? No, good, okay. Okay, so all this stuff is still here in the physical, like there's still physical space here. Okay, so now I just need to make sure I'm going to the right location. Because I moved all this data somewhere else. But I didn't change where anything else is. So everything else is still in its actual location. All right, so let me go back to that place right there. So 503E2. 503E2. And our new location is 48. Okay. All right, and so the order of the bytes there is going to be reverse of what it looks like in the raw, and that has to do with the way the processor orders things when you work with it. Okay, and this is going to be true in pretty much everything. It's going to be the case in pretty much everything. I wrote into empty space, and I did a paste right or a paste overwrite. I didn't do a paste right. So 48 0200. Okay, so if I take something here, like say I have, you know, gobbledygook here, and I copy that, there's two different kinds of paste. So if I go to paste insert and paste right, if I do paste insert, I'm gonna get a warning. It'll change the file size and that will mess up pointers. All right, that will change jumps. So I don't do that. Instead, I'm gonna use paste right, which is control B, paste right. And what that does is it fills in the space. It overwrites what's currently there. Okay, so that avoids messing up any pointers. Okay. So I did not push anything down. I overwrote what was in place when I pasted this. Okay. All right. So at 50395, right? No, that was net E3. It's the other way around. Whatever. So BF000048. So those bytes are in reverse order. So I said that was the beginning of 48. The 48 bank, so it'd be 480000. So when I do the call there, the load, I'm using BF, which is the command for the load, 000048. All right, so those bytes are in reversed order. I have expanded. I expanded the ROM. So the ROM is originally 3 megabytes. And I have expanded that to 6. So I have all of this free space here. It is all totally empty, with the exception of stuff that I have put there. And that is the absolute largest you can make a Super Nintendo ROM and still have it work on most things. Okay, so before they started doing expansion for the ROM, yeah, making sure you manage your space was really important, for obvious reasons. And for a long time, in fact, most people still do, expand up to 4 megabytes. And recently, and you kind of have to do this not manually, there's this different application you can use to do it, to expand it to 6 megabytes. But it has a couple caveats to it. And that all goes, that goes pretty deep into how the Super Nintendo actually works. And I don't 100% understand it. I kind of just know basically what I need to do. So I'm not going to jump into that too much further. But essentially, I just gave myself more space to work with. And I have the most amount of free space. So I'll get down about halfway through the ROM here, and you'll see, look, F. All this F, all blank, okay? F, blank, 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 blank. And you see, like, I'm only halfway through the ROM, and this is almost entirely free space, okay? I've got a couple things that I stuck in there. Alright? Got a couple things that I stuck in there. But, for all intents and purposes, this is all empty. It's all empty. I've got a little bit here, also. And that's the sprite sheets that I reordered, put in there. Okay, so this is all expanded data for me to do things with. And I'm pretty sure I will never fill all of that up. I'm really hoping I never fill all of that up. Goodness gracious. Alright, so that's how far we are. I have moved the instrument code. And let's go ahead and test that before we do anything else. Let's make sure that that is doing what it's supposed to do. Alright, so I got rid of all the old instrument data, so in order for songs to work at all, it's got to be running it from the new code. So let's go ahead and just launch the ROM. Did I do that in the right one? Okay, good. I was going to be really annoyed if I did that in the wrong ROM. All right, let me turn this up loud enough that I can hear. Hopefully you guys don't get too much doubled sound from it picking up on my mic. You know, even if it takes me... Even if I'm 87 years old, I still only be about halfway to my scheduled release date for the ROM, so that's actually okay. Right, let's make sure this works. I hear things. Do you hear things? All right. Instrument data works. All of our instrument data works. We've got our songs. All right, so that's the instrument data. So now I need to work on expanding the actual songs. Okay, so there's more to it than that. That is just step one. That is step one. But it's successful, and this is my first time doing this, so I'm pretty happy. So yeah, let's go back over to the tutorial. I'm basically following a tutorial on stream. I'm supposed to be like the expert doing this stuff on stream, but whatever. Whatever, this is new. I'm okay with that. As long as you're okay with that, I'm okay with that. Okay, we'll rustle through it together. Alright, so I relocated that. I changed where it called it in the code. Last thing to do is change the code for the maximum number of songs. Okay, and I'm going to be adding 2 songs. So let's go ahead and we'll change that. That'll be a really easy one. That's 5-3-C, so it'll be D-E. 5-3-E. 5-E. Let's go through 2. 5-3-E. 5-E. And it should be 5-5, and it is. And so I'm just going to change that to 5-7, because I'm adding 2 songs tonight. Yes, I know. Everyone's going to have to congratulate Geen Attack for writing a comprehensible tutorial. It is what we watched today. Alright, so I'm adding 2 songs tonight, so I'm just going to change that to 5-7. What's next? So if you add 1 song, it's going to go to 56, 2 songs, 57. Hey, there you go. That's good that he has that recap. Alright, so just add on to the pointer table at C5-3E-9-6 pointers. So the original instrument samples are right under the song pointers, so you can erase all of that and or overwrite it to make room for the additional song pointers. Okay, so there you go. So those song pointers were actually right before that data that I moved, so which means I should be able to go right into my song pointers. All right, and that's actually the only other thing, because the instruments didn't need a pointer. That was actually just a spot in code. That's good. I think I can do this. All right, so 53E96. 53E, so F0, so it'd be 4096. Okay, and so this is where the songs go, and again, it's going to be in that Endian, it's called Endian order, that backwards order. So the first song is located at C8, 5C7A. And where I can actually check this, because I actually have a list of all the songs and where they're located in the data. And you see C8, 5C7A. It's right here. Song number one, C8, 5C7A. Song two, C8, 5CAO. Prelude, right here. C8, 5CAO. All right, so we know we're in the right spot. It's nice that you can check all this stuff. There's ways to check it so you're not actually running blind. Nah. You know what? You are probably right about that. You are probably right about that. But that's okay, because we love him anyway, right? He does good work. All right, so we're going to get all the way down here. The last song is C9DF3F. And where are we going? Right here. No, that's actually not where I'm going. I wanted to go here. So the last song, it says, should be C9DF3F, and it is. So I should be able to just add a pointer right under that for my next song. Okay, so my next song, I'm actually just going to jump a whole bank. And we're going to go to 4.9 is going to be the beginning of my first imported song. All right, so I need to add a new instrument sample, and I need to add a new song. So the instrument sample is going to go at the bottom of where I moved my instrument samples to, because that is worked out automatically. I don't need a pointer for that. It's because it's consistently spaced. That's how they made that work. And then now I've got the pointer here to where the actual song data is. So that should be all I need. And I'm really hoping this works, because I would love to hear determination in my ROM. Okay, so let's go ahead and we'll open up the data. All right, so let me go into music. Actually, is that where I want it? That's not where I want it. I actually want to go into documentation, my code music. And here we go. These are the two files here. The song data and the instrument data. Okay, so I actually need to grab this. I'm gonna pull it over here for a second so that I can pull the instrument data over and the song data over into my hex editor. All right, so instrument data right here. I'm gonna copy that. All right, and I moved it to the 480200. Okay, so this was all of our instrument data, and so that means my very first one is gonna go right here. So instrument data for determination, copy it, and we're gonna use the paste write, not paste insert. Okay, so there's my instrument data, and now I need my song data. So this is the whole song. And I'm gonna copy that, control copy that, pop over here, and I'm gonna go to the very next bank, which is where I'm gonna start my actual song imports. And I have reserved the entire 4.8, 4.9, 4A, 4B, 4C, 4D, 4E, 4F, all for just music for the rest of my ROM. Okay, so I have plenty, plenty, plenty of space. Put the stuff in there, so I'm not that worried about it. All right, so I'm at 4.9, and I have the 2 in here because of the header, so this is the beginning of the 4.9 bank, and paste right. Okay, so I've got a song, I've got instrument data, I just need something to change the music to the new song, which is number 5.6 now, and You know what I want to do? I want to add that. I don't want that there. I'm going to want that here. What? Oh, this is not what I wanted. That's not what I wanted. This is it, right? New song list. Where do I have that right now? Yeah, so that's going to be hex 5-6. So this is what we're going to do. In order to check to see if this works... Actually, I do have an event place that I'm going to put this, but just for testing purposes. Yeah, I need to make sure I don't have it open somewhere else. All right, so I've got my instrument data, I've got the song data, and I put the pointer in. So let's save it. I'm going to go ahead and close that because I don't want to accidentally change things. All right, so now let's open it up. And we are going to go ahead and launch this with my new event commands, with my new battle commands. I'm sorry. So that's FBOE. 5-6, I believe. That should be change song. Right? FBOE should be change song to 5-6. Alright, so we're going to save this. I'm going to turn my volume up, and I don't care that much if you guys can hear it, because this is a momentous occasion for me, personally. That's right, I'll turn it down pretty quick, actually. I just want to make sure that it works. Alright, let me go back into here. Play. In fact, oops. Oh man, stupid adaptive keyboard. All right, I'm crossing my fingers. Kind of expect things to go wrong the first time. All right, come on, let me hear it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Where's the music? No! What'd I do wrong? No, what did I do wrong? I knew it! Sounds like nothing. Okay, so we gotta do something with this. This is where the debugger comes in. Hold on, let me go back to the tutorial first and make sure I didn't miss a step. Okay, so I changed the total number of songs to 5-5. Let me verify that I'm doing the right command on my AI code. No, I definitely am, because the music stopped from before. I wrote the code, so there's no reason it should stop on that particular byte. So yeah, let me go back to here. Alright, change the total number of songs. I did that. Just add to the new song pointer tables. Or instrument sense. Unless I got my instruments wrong and now it's just looking at blanks. So let's put a... I'm going to put a break right here. So I'm going to use my my debugger here. Unless there's a different place that calls music in battle, but I doubt it. C5 01E2 01E2 execute. Okay, run. Go, 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 go. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Did I already break this? Oh, that's right. It's gonna do it every time it runs a song. Hold on. Go, 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 go. Oh, this is totally going to crash. I can feel it. I think it's already crashing. What did I do? I think something on the song call must be wrong. What did I do? Hold on, let me see if it does that when I... it's a fresa fresa resin. Let me run it here and see if I... It does the same thing here. So I broke something. I'm not sure what I broke, but I broke something. Okay. What did I break? It couldn't have been the song data. Couldn't have been the song pointer because that stuff didn't get moved. No problem, Dastern. Thanks for coming out. I don't have to fix the track pointers. They all stay the... Wait, the track pointers? Aren't the track pointers... You mean the track pointers within the song? Aren't they a relative jump? Or are they absolute? Adios, Dastern. All right, man. Someone get Gein Attack on here to tell me what I did wrong. All right. Here we go. All right, open with. I don't want to change too much stuff. All right, so we tested the instrument samples. We know that that was pulling correctly, right? Maybe I did something wrong. I don't know. All right. Within the song, they are relative to the bank. That still wouldn't have messed up the song that got messed up, like when the game crashed. I must have done another random thing wrong. All right, hold on real quick. I'm going to take a step back and I'm going to rename this to 2. No, and I'm going to actually get rid of that. And I'm going to go ahead and use my backup, which should be this one here before I made that change. In fact, the first thing I did was just I made a change where I just changed the number of songs, and that was the only thing, and I hit save. And the thing is, look, it runs these songs. Maybe this did happen when I did the when I changed the instrument data. So let me go back and double check that. In fact, I'm gonna set that same breakpoint I set, and I'll run it again. So I did have a problem. I just loaded state, so I skipped that entire thing. So that's interesting. All right. So run breakpoint for. For this C501E2, right? C501E2. All right, so I don't care if it breaks like 8 times. I need to find out when it does the wrong thing here. All right, so we've got it. And it's gonna, it's gonna run it each time for each instrument. So it should run, what, 16 times, right? Or 8 times? I don't know, it's one of those two. Oh, geez, is that gonna keep running every time? Oh, geez, that just runs constantly during the... Yeah. Shoot, how am I gonna know if it breaks? Oh, it's running now. And it's just running the song, so okay. Alright. Alright, alright, alright. So we'll step into... So what did it look... Ah! F-A-A-D. You know, I'm just going to do this for a while. And see where it breaks. Which it could be a very, very long way in here, so I don't know that this is exactly the smartest thing to do. In fact, let's step out. It's still running. Step out, step out, step out. Not broken yet. Just make sure that this is supposed to loop as many times as it is. Am I stuck in a loop? Is that what's happening? Is anything different in any of this? In fact, if I just run and I start hitting this. Alright, so I am stuck in a loop. I don't know what I did to get stuck in a loop. So, I broke something. I must have changed a byte I was not supposed to. So let me start by restoring the stuff that I grabbed. So let's go ahead and let's kill this. Yeah. Yep. Isn't hacking fun? It'd be nice if this went smoothly, but then it wouldn't be realistic, right? Alright, so open with hex editor. Alright. So it's not necessarily the instrument data where I went wrong. That, for all intents and purposes, might have been working. No. It didn't start the song because it went blank, so there was something. There definitely is something. I didn't do any returns. All I did was I made edits. So I'm not going to the song data. I think it's in something else. What did I just do? Yeah, come on. There we go. All right. Get my brain around what's going on here. Let me go to... Alright, so I need to go back to my instrument data, and I'm going to copy that back in to its original location and see if that fixes anything. Actually, you know what? Let's go back one step at a time. Let me fix this first. C5, 3C, 5E. Should be 5, 3E, 5E. That should be a 57 currently. I'm just going to change that back to 55 real quick. Let's just see real quick if that makes a difference. No. Still broken. That wasn't it. Alright, so the other thing was the instrument data that I changed everything to FF. Alright, so where did I put that? I went to 4.8. Jump all the way down to here. Maybe it doesn't jump. No, you know what? It's this regular code. There's no reason that should not jump properly into 4.8. Not to mention it was running the songs too, so... It was getting something. It must be another thing that I accidentally, like, must have nicked when I wasn't paying attention. I didn't change any of the pointers for any of the songs. Oh, hold on, I did this. I did that. Well, no, I just did that right here. But that's the blank song. something I was doing when I was screwing around. You know, that's the kind of thing that gets me. Okay, so I just broke the nothing song when I was showing off the paste write versus paste insert. Oh, I'm a dummy. I did okay. That's all right. That's all right. It's okay. Let's put all this stuff back. This is not good for my health. All right. All right, let's put that back. Instrument data, copy that. Go to 4.8. Go back down here. Paste right. And then we're gonna go 5.3E, 5.E. Change back to 57. And we'll save it. I think I got it. Yeah, Hold on. I unbroke it at the beginning anyway. Let's check to see if make sure that that's not what's happening first, and then I can go back and look at that. So I did all that. All right, well this part works, so that's not broken any longer. And actually, I can just do that. Yes, I get it. Come on, let me hear the song. Oh, whoops, I took out the change in the, I need to reload this. Otherwise, it'll overwrite the stuff I just did. Alright, children of vector. Battle script. X insert. FBOE. 5.6. Okay, save. I know, right? All these little things. I need this properly expanded. If not, I'll just have Mike do it for me tomorrow. But still, I would like this to work on stream. Okay, I don't hear anything. Alright, so now I have to go look at the track pointers. Alright, so where are the track pointers located? That's at the beginning? Because I do not have that information. Like, why would I get a binary and then not have the information for the track pointers? Because I don't know where the tracks start and end. I mean, I can go in here. Do I have something that he shows me? Like, I don't know what I'm looking for here exactly. Okay, so this is the song. Are these the track pointers? Is that the first bunch of things? I see that there is kind of a repetition going on here. All right, so let me go into the hacking, because there actually is another guide about hacking specific songs, and this was just on the total songs. So let's go into music hacking. Yeah. All right, so where do I find the track pointers? Now that we have established some understanding of the structure, let's examine a song. We're going to look at the battle theme. Now, locate battle theme, instruments. So I already have that. I don't think that's the problem we had. The song sequence. Let's take a look at the battle theme again. We're going to look at the hex itself. First part, channel pointers. Here's what you see. Okay, so now I'm not really sure about function. Channel data starts at 69FE. This says that channel 1 will play the data at 090069, first to the last two digits. Okay. All right, I should have listened to you in the first place, but I had to straighten out the stuff that I was doing. I had to straighten out the stuff that I had already done wrong. Okay. So how do I know the beginning? Is there a certain command that ends a track? SPCC header will be 24 bytes, all 16-bit pairs. Okay, so when I'm looking at this, there's what, eight? There's eight tracks. And he said that the first couple, at least up here, he said the first couple bytes, he's not sure what they are. But it should be like every two after that, right? Like that's 69FE. Okay. Eight channel pointers duplicated, which is why I see which is why that is duplicated. This all looks duplicated right there. Okay, how do I decipher this? And how do I figure out where I'm going in here? Somebody's got to give me that information. So there's a step that I'm missing here about figuring this stuff out. That's the header there. And so 9BF2 is the beginning of my pointers here. Why couldn't they just be relative to where they are in the song? Because then it would be always the same. Yeah. Open link in a 2-tab. Pa-ching. Okay. Oh, man. All right. So, how do I know where to put this stuff? That starts at track left, track right, which is why all that's doubled. And so that's going to start at... So what you're telling me... What you're telling me is... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right? That's header there. And then that is 1, and that should be 2. Why are those different? Oh, because it's... Wait. Is it 3 bytes? 02, 02... Okay. Awesome. I'm assuming that's a scene for Children of Vectors Atris. If so, make sure it's on the, make sure it's where I can get to it. The first byte would be at 0026. Right here? Why is this so confusing? Well, yeah. Okay, because here... Oh, I'm sorry. Those are addresses. I was thinking that that... I'm a dummy. Ignore me. Ignore me as best as you possibly can. It should... I mean, that looks like it's telling me I should be starting... I should be starting right here. And that's why that's doubled. Okay, and so this is where he put each of those. And he actually put... Okay, I'm getting it now. I'm getting it now. He put these at the beginning of F1. Which is why that's all, why that's 3-1. Oh, wait, hold on. Or are these relative to... These are all relative to right here, right? So 26... should be the beginning of the song data. See you, Zatris. Sorry if this is not super exciting for people. This is what hacking looks like. Two six zero zero three one zero zero. So it looks like what he... No, never mind. Okay. Okay. Now it's only showing 2 bytes per... But the problem is, I need to make sure I know when the, you can add, I think, the song offset to all his values. But that's the thing. I didn't, it's actually at the beginning of a bank, so there shouldn't have to be an offset. It should actually just be in place. Right? Go to 49. Maybe I put it in the wrong place. 0200. So I'm at the very beginning of the 49 bank when I start the song data. Okay, so I'm at 490000. So just in 0000, this should be this should be correct. 26, which would mean this would be the beginning of the data for channel 1. Channel 2 would start at 131. There's going to be 331, which would start at D4, D9. Channel 2 would be 2-4-A, so 4-4-A. 4-4-A, D4, D9. Okay, so that's all making sense. I don't think this is imported wrong. Unless there's something else wrong with this. Unless I did... Oh, you know what I didn't also change? Shoot. Another dumb mistake. All right. When I went back and I remade my changes, I forgot to add the pointer to the song. I forgot to put the pointer back to the song. Yep. That's my day. That is my day. Right here. Okay. 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 It's almost anticlimactic now. Although I really hope it still works. Of course not. Alright, what else did I do wrong? I'm not frozen. Oh yeah, now I am. Okay. So I still have something else wrong in there. I just don't know what. Unless it doesn't know, because I know this should work, because this is the same place that he does a lot of his song imports. No, he put his instrument samples later on. That should still be fine. Maybe what I should do is drop it in here to test it, just in case. Are we talking relative to the bank or relative to... Yeah, I did that one. Right, that was at 5-3-E-5-E. Yeah, I changed that also. Let's do 5-6, even though that shouldn't matter. Because I've only done one song so far. But that shouldn't matter because everything else... Oh, crap. I don't think I saved last time. I must not have saved. Hold on. Because this is gone now. This change. I'll tell you what. I will tell you what. Little things. Little things. No, it's right here. It's not a preemptive strike anymore, also. Something's not right. Am I loading the right ROM? Oh, you know what? I bet I'm loading number 2. Remember, because I had made a back... No, that's not the number 2 one. What am I editing? Yeah. Now it's preemptive. Come on. Okay. Oops. Yeah. But you see, it's doing things actually different. Like, I'm not getting preemptive strikes anymore? Like, why is that a thing? Now watch, I'll go in here, I'll change the one thing. And it's going to change... Okay. So, just in case, totally crazy. I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna change this back to 56. And I'm just gonna let this start from a new game. Go, 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 come on. I'm gonna figure this out, dang it. Thing is, the song should at least be changing. It should at least be going blank or something, right? Okay. Okay. All right, so you're at 56. 54000. So that I'm getting over here. 000049 for song 56. Okay. Go to I know the instrument data is working correctly. Four nine zero two zero zero. There's the beginning of the song. I've got to be doing something wrong. All right, so what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna copy this real quick. I'm gonna go back to here. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna go somewhere in the F bank. And of course, I can't use that. So let's go 3 8. Got nothing here? Okay. Alright, so now 5 4. Just to make sure it's not like a X high ROM thing. So I just went to what, 3 8? So if that's what's going on, we can try to work that out. Song's still not changing. All right, there's got to be something else. There's got to be something left out. There's got to be something I'm doing wrong. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna change that back to 4 9 now, and we'll go to 3 8. Also, I did it at the wrong spot, like a dummy, but that doesn't really matter. Because it would at least do something. All right, so it's got to be a thing. Thank you, Lock Kirby. Okay, let me think. Let me think. I put it right at the beginning of the bank, which means this should work. Man, the one night I need him on. I should have double checked with him earlier today. All right, well, just for fun, let's go ahead and try the other song he sent me, just in case that is a thing. I'll make sure I did put that in there, right? Real quick, go to 480200. That should be the last song here. Yep, that is the same. Yep, that is definitely the same. Is there something wrong with these? It wasn't playing like a blank song, it just wasn't changing the song. Alright, let me try to set the song up a different way. Just in case it's something in that code. Let's do this. Let's replace Awakening. And let's make a new something or other. Whatever. I'm not going to save it anyway. Shoot, I can't save that here. This is my official ROM. I can't really undo all that, so never mind. Let's get all that and delete it. I can't do that. No, wait, yes I can. Yes I can, because I don't have to do it. I just have to change the, all I have to do is change the pointer. So what I can do, of course this would just make it weird sounds. So let me go ahead and I'll change Prelude, the pointer for Prelude. Really? Oh, I'm in the wrong. Oh shoot, I need the actual address for that. Added more total songs. And no. Wait, the pointers. Pointer list. That's this one. Starting here, right? So this should be Prelude right here. Eh, whatever. 000049. Let's see if I can't get that to work. Yep. Okay. It's doing something. It might still be something in the song data. Let me go and change the instruments for Awakening. Four eight zero two zero zero. It's going to be the second batch. Make sure, no, that definitely should work. So now I have the right instruments for the song. Come on. All right, there's the song. That is the song. The buzzing was the instruments being wrong. This is the song. So it's not the location. It's not the instruments. It is something about loading the song number. I didn't have to change anything. Apparently that all worked. It's just a matter of this is such a good stinking song. Alright. Okay. Alright, so let's go back and I'll try to figure out what silly thing I missed. So we're going to get rid of that and we're going to fix your song data. And we're going to go back to 54000. Find your song right there. Make sure I get the right one in the info for Awakening. Or Prelude, I mean. AO5CC8. And real quick, make sure that works before I continue. Okay. So we're that far. I need a C5 disassembly. I wonder if there is one. I want to look at the code surrounding the byte that I changed in regards to how many maximum songs. Okay. Unless there's another place that changes the thing that gets me, though, is that it didn't change. Maybe it's just my code that changes things. Maybe I skipped. No, that wouldn't work. It has to be able to change the songs. All right, so I'm going to hop back into the debugger now. And I'm going to set the breakpoint for C5 0. You know what? I'm going to set the breakpoint to 48 to the instrument data for the song and see if that gets loaded. It should be 480200, and then starting right here. So CA0. 0CA0. Read. All right. And SS9X does not fast forward as fast as ZSNSW. We're gonna get this. We're gonna do it. It's gonna be a thing. Go, 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 go. Alright, so hold on, before we go any further now, let's pause real quick. Where's my save state? Isn't there supposed to be a thing around here? Is it Shift F1 for save? I do not want to do the wrong thing, but I don't have the, I do not have the bar. Am I missing something here? Alt, Control, I'm trying those. All right, I'm just gonna do Shift F1 and hope for the best. All right, good. All right, so it didn't run it, but let me go ahead and Let me go ahead and see if it's going to run the code to C5. No, that's not what I want. C501E2. C501E2. Okay. Run. Currently, it's not even running the code. So it could be that I have it, and there's something wrong with my code in here. Oh, there it is, escape. Alright, so this is what we're going to do. I'm going to make an event edit and try it in there. Okay, so I'm going to just make a real simple one. I know exactly where I'm going to do it, too. Documentation, no wait, events, and ancient castle inside, down towards the bottom, I should have a change of song when they go to talk to L'Oreal after the battle with the necromancer. Yeah, I don't want that. It's before they teleport. Actually, I can do this one. No, wait, never mind. That uses the song for, not there. Alright. Fade in, Song Awakening, right here. Okay, so that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for F1 05 80 or something like that. Right before, I actually used to use text boxes to help me find it faster. All right, so go to oh shoot, where did I put this stuff? 3A something 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 something. Someone tell me where this is. Let me highlight that so I can see that when I get there later. All right, FA0A70. So 0C70. And then from here, I'm going to look for display 4B6A00. All right, so I'm going to find hex 4B6A, oops, 6A00, going forward, right there. So this is the song right here. Fade in song. Oh, Awakening isn't actually what I use there. It's a different song. And 80 is the speed, so I'm going to use 5.6 right here. Okay? What did I just change that from? Hold on. OE. Not Awakening. I'm using Rachel. Fix that. Okay. HXD. Because I actually have a save point literally right before that. Let me hop back into this. Go back to here. I have save state right before that moment. Right here. But I hear nothing. I still hear nothing. Okay, so we've got a problem with songs above the original set. That's our problem. It's a problem somewhere in there. Even though I increased the number of songs, and I will verify that again in case somehow I got mixed up. But I'm pretty sure I've done that like 4 times now. Add on to the pointer table for any new pointers. The original instrument samples, random the instrument song, you have the song pointers. I just don't see what thing I'm missing here. Well, I knew there was a transition there. I didn't have that saved for that reason. I actually had that there for showing off Vargas in movement when I was making sure everything looked good. You missed the very beginning of the stream, but that's what I did. I was showing off the Vargas sprite animations. Alright. Alright. So 5CE5E. 5CE5E. Should be 5-3-E-5-E, excuse me. 56. Or 5-6, technically. Let me see what that code is supposed to look like. I guess this is just a data point. I think there might be a C5 disassembly in FF3US documents. Otherwise, I might have to look through it. No, I have up through C4. Crap. Alright. This looks like data of sorts. I don't know why that. Man, I would hate to call it a night, but we've got it narrowed down to the thing that's hanging us up is the wrong songs. Like, it's not going to the next pointer, but it doesn't even look like it was running the code. So let me see when it runs this in the debugger and find out what it does with that. Maybe it's the fact that, no, it can't be the fact that I'm using save states, because we checked that. We started the game over from scratch. All right. What is this? C5. 3C5E. Read. Heck, read, write, execute. Just one of those things. One of those things work. We should get one pretty close to right now, right? And what is this doing here? It's comparing the song number, which this is Prelude that's getting, or not Prelude, something, I don't know. Awakening, I think. And then checks to see that. Okay. And it works. And we're like, hooray, it worked. Right? Yeah, stop checking it. We get it. Oh wait, I did put a save state in. No. Haha. Wait, breakpoint. Okay, make sure it's still running. So CF E3. It's comparing it to this thing right here. C5 3C5E, just that right there. Okay, and there it is. Okay, so it's running the code. Haha. It's running it here, and look, 5-6 is what it's checking it against. Step into branch of carry set. And it did not branch, which means it should be going on to do the song, right? Store zero for this. Pull all the things. E9ED. We're back in C2. Okay, so other times that ran, did I change a different... I didn't change any other values. So hypothetically, if I change that to 5.7, will it work? Alright, so let's reset and make sure when it runs this code that it's I'm gonna skip the first couple for the darkness just in case. Alright, it's 2. Branch of carry set. E3, which would be a backwards jump, which is what it was doing there. So it's branching incorrectly, but this is the byte it's checking it against. C5 3 C5 E. Okay, because of the header, that's an E instead of a C. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm just gonna change this to like 80. All right. Oh, but I obviously have to reload the ROM if I'm going to do that. To make sure that I'm actually loading the right thing. Okay. Breakpoint. All right, we've got this narrowed down to what's stopping it from working now. You hit me, it breaks, it's comparing it. We should not be going backwards now, and we're not. Okay, so we should get the song. Okay, so now we don't have nothing happening, but we do still have it not playing the song. So that makes me wonder if it's getting the instrument data, if it's doing anything like that. So let's put a breakpoint at, it doesn't look like it's doing anything. In fact, the game craps out on me when I try to do anything else. I might have to call it, guys. I might have to call this. Man. Or maybe there's extra song, like, instruments in there. And so now it's actually looking at the next one. Like, maybe it's not pulling the right one, so it's blank. It might be pulling bad songs. That's the only thing I can think of right now. Okay, so, like, if I go to 480200... 1, 2, 3. Well, okay. You know what? I can. This is already in hex, so all I need to do is divide whatever number I get to down here by 2. So that C9. Alright. So if I do C9. Divide that by 2, I get 64. I get 64. How is that right? Each one of these is only 2 things. Is this all other data? I must have gone to the wrong spot. I'm gonna, I must have gone to the wrong spot. I don't know if I lost you guys. Maybe I should refresh this. Hold on. Do I have a refresh button over here? How big is this guy right here? Okay. What now? C50193. Is that where it was supposed to end before? I hope I didn't delete something that I was supposed to keep. But that would be a kind of thing that I would do wrong. In fact, it might be this right here. Because if that was 64, that would put this at 65, and I would need to go back basically one hex, which would put me down to right about there. Right. Okay. I did skip a step in there. All right, hold on. So what's that C50193? Was that a thing? Or is that another? I'll just go there, whatever you say. 50393. Compare to 54. Oh, is there another one of these for the instruments? That's a compare. All right, so let me go ahead and up this to, let me up that to 56. Where'd you find that at? Was that somewhere in here? Is there a reason I should have been able to find that? Still blank. Okay. Oh, they do have one on Slick Productions? Okay, cool. Hold on. I'll increase this to 80 because that's what I did for the other one. Still crashing on me. Still broken. Still broken. Alright, what was I looking at before? I was making sure my instrument data, I copied the correct instrument data. 54195. 54195. I really did not intend for this part to take the whole night. I know Mike's going to watch this later, and he's going to be like, oh, I forgot to mention, or something like that. He's going to know exactly what it is. Alright. So that started here, but where was it supposed to end? 4C34. I think that is where I ended, actually. 4C34. No header. Unless there's supposed to be a little byte there. I'm pretty sure that's not it. Because this should be... Because I started on a 5, right? So it would make sense for that to be... Yep. Okay, so I copy the right data. Four eight zero. Yeah, but I changed that, and then it still was broken, so I changed it back for now. Yeah, I know. I know how compare works. Unless I did it, and I mean, were you watching? Did I do the wrong thing? 3, 9, 4 should have been, yeah, C9, and this was 5, 4, and I changed that to like 80, 80. And that was, it was still, it was that, I don't think that's what's hanging me up. And so I went ahead and I just changed that back to what it was before. I don't know that that's what's hanging me up. You know what, whatever. I'll leave it like this. And I can make a change to that later if I have to. And then branch, or whatever kind of branch that is, that Dio is. And then it's comparing to a bunch of other things here. So maybe. I wonder if I'm getting stuck in that loop again that I was stuck in at the beginning. Oh, it's getting late. It's getting late, and I gotta work tomorrow. Skmm. I need that open. I don't think the problem is with these. I don't think the problem is with... I really don't think the problem is with this. I was... Actually, you know what? Yeah, I was at the right song. I forgot to subtract... 200. So I was at the right number song. So this is right. The song data is right. So yeah, there's definitely something keeping me from being able to play the song. And it does not seem like... Let's go back into the event, actually. Again, we'll... Canada Day. What in the world is Canada Day? Well, I'm off on Monday for 4th of July. Yeah, and it even freezes here. And it's not like a frozen, I think it's stuck in a loop. And I don't know what's causing the loop or how to break it. It's stuck in some kind of temporal loop. That's what I'm going to call it anyway. Alright, so I've got something up to test it. Let me write down that address, because I don't have that saved somewhere else. 0193 that compare to 54. Okay, so I can do more research on that tomorrow. I can believe it. I'm gonna have to do more research on this tomorrow, or ask Mike whenever he gets up, and he'll be like, oh, it's this, and I'll be like, okay, it's that. And then I will be sure to tell you all next week on the stream what I so stupidly overlooked. Because I'm sure it's just something I'm doing. It's gotta be. It's gotta be. When we played it on the other song, it worked just fine. It's something with expanding the songs. All right. That's going to be all for tonight. I'm sorry we didn't get more accomplished. Hopefully the stuff that I showed at the beginning was at least interesting, because I know the rest of this probably wasn't. Judging by the fact that there are only two people that are actively chatting right now. But that's all right. I'm going to get into some more interesting stuff soon. actually, so I'll be doing some event edits, and next week might even involve some map editing. I'm going to be making a custom dungeon. So that should be better. Yeah, so that's what we're going to do next week, unless something else comes up. But I'm going to get this ironed out, and hey, Smasher. I'm actually getting ready to log out. Thank you guys for helping out. You guys helped me narrow down a few couple things, and we'll get this ironed out, and I'll scream it all over Discord chat and be like, I can't believe I did this. And then we'll go from there. All right, so thank you guys. Have a good evening and happy hacking. I will see you next time.